Hey, I'm Donald Bell for Cool Tools, and in this video, I'm going to show you a new $200 portable welding table from DeWalt and how it compares to a $70 Harbor Freight welding table that I started out on and I'm sure a lot of you are familiar with. You can find links to both of them down in the description. First, let me just say that I am an amateur weekend welder. I learned to weld a few years ago so that I could make my own electric go-karts. If you're looking for a professional's opinion, this is not the video for you. That said, neither of these tables are made for professionals. The best welding tables are heavy slabs of perfectly flat steel. These are both made from punched and folded sheet metal. Neither of them are ideal. The DeWalt is noticeably bigger at 46 inches wide and 18 inches deep. The Harbor Freight is smaller, but a little deeper at 30 by 20. The only significant thing I can say about the differences between the actual table surface is that the DeWalt includes all these holes in the top. On a conventional welding table, these would all be 5/8 inch holes for expensive drop-in welding clamps. But for better or worse, these are all 3/4 inch holes, which are more typical for workbenches and can accept most bench dog type accessories. As far as I can tell, the real benefit of having these is that you can pop in a few dogs and square things up pretty quickly. It also opens things up to making your own custom jigs and fixtures that you can bolt down. If you liked having the little flimsy pop-up rails on the Harbor Freight table to square things up, you can use these in the same way and have a lot more flexibility. Another big difference between these two tables are the legs. The Harbor Freight connects their legs in the middle, which gives you some nice clamping clearance all the way around the edges. The downside is that when you go to clamp something in the middle, you always run into the leg hardware, which you can't see from the top, and it makes it frustrating to plan your clamp down. On the DeWalt table, the legs are out at the edges, and your clamps won't knock into them unless you're planning on clamping right at the corner. Usually that's where I'm trying to weld, not clamp, so I prefer this design. Which is good because this table doesn't have corners anyway. They're all punched in like this. Now, why would you do this? I suspect it's because if you're welding a right angle connection that meets up at the corner, this design lets you tack every side of it without flipping it over. Or if you do flip it, your first weld doesn't prevent the piece from sitting flush. So for me, I'd say those are all wins for the DeWalt, but for most of us, still probably not enough to justify an extra $130 over the Harbor Freight. Where I think the DeWalt earns its price tag is how well it travels and folds up. As a weekend welder with a small garage, I'm always setting up the table and breaking it down. I'll even take it out into the yard sometimes to do grinding out there. For as small as the Harbor Freight table is, it's pretty awkward to carry around. The DeWalt includes this big handle, and the balance is nice, sort of like a heavy guitar case. You can remove the handle, though, if you find it gets in the way. Another cool feature is that while it's folded up, you can just pop this on a workbench you already have and use it right away. There's feet on the bottom here that insulate it from your table. My only complaint here is that the plastic is a little soft. Already, after just a few weeks of sliding this in and out of storage, the plastic has worn down a lot. Still, there are a bunch of small touches on the DeWalt that are pretty clever. You get this eye bolt on the side that's perfect for holding your torch, or you can use it as a ground clamp. On the other side, though, they have this dedicated grounding bolt that you can either clamp to or attach your ground wire to directly. Like the handle, though, you can choose whether you want to attach these or not, and they can be screwed on and off easily. Same goes for these cable guides that you can attach to one of the legs. You can use these to take up some of the slack from your cables or direct them towards the ground so you're not hopping over them. I find myself actually tripping on these more than my cables, but maybe you'll feel differently about it. The best thing about these legs, which I haven't mentioned yet, is that you can adjust their height. If your back hurts from hunching over low tables like the Harbor Freight, the DeWalt comes up a full 4 inches higher to 36 inches. I'm not a tall guy, but even I find it physically easier to work with it raised up a few inches and easier to see too. Locking pins are included to keep it at your preferred height or just as an added safety precaution. The table is rated to support up to 1,000 pounds, and even with the legs extended all the way out, you can still fold it down, no problem. That's about all I have to say about it. I'm glad I made the upgrade. It's not the perfect welding table, but I can't imagine a better portable welding table, especially for someone like me who just needs to drag this thing out occasionally and doesn't want it taking up too much space. You can find links to everything down in the description, including some of my favorite budget welding tools like this Hobart MIG welder, the gloves, the mask, the nicer clamps, and the respirator. And remember, you can find thousands of reader-recommended tools like these at cool-tools.org.